we are discussing about self confidence. So this is a very common challenging situation to everyone, and we always feel necessity of confidence, whether it may be our office, whether we are preparing for any exam, whether we want to attend any meeting, whether we want to participate in any social gathering. So each and every field we require confidence. So could you please tell us, Swamiji, as how to cultivate self-confidence? Over to you, Swamiji.
Self-confidence, it is a very interesting topic to ponder on it. A beautiful idea. See, confidence is the feeling of assurance or satisfaction arising from one's appreciation of one's abilities and qualities. So self-confidence is feelings of appreciation, your abilities and qualities. Confidence comes from the success of the life. Success comes from consistent practice and faith in yourself. As Swami Vivekananda used to say, faith, faith, faith in yourself. All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. So, confidence, we can build the confidence through the success by constant practicing and having a tremendous faith on yourself, all power within. But sometimes we feel very low and we have low self-esteem, that as if you are small. But you should not lose that self-confidence by thinking a beautiful quotation by Upanishad, Katha Upanishad. Bahunanimi Pathama, Bahunanimi Mathama. I am first among many, second among many. So you should not lose the confidence. Always imbibe this confidence, that self-satisfaction, self-assurance, and your that abilities and qualities of the life. But here one thing you should remember: self-confidence turns into arrogance. It is dangerous for the growth. Confidence means self-confidence where he thinks I'm the best because everybody is appreciating me. I want to appreciation from others. Thinking like that, one day you'll think I am the best in the world. So this is arrogance. Self-confidence turns into arrogance the moment you think you are the best in the world, you're the best. No other person is there better than you. And your nature will be that you want to hear appreciation from others. You are not ready to hear any appreciation from other people than you. So this is all self-confidence turned into arrogance or arrogancy. It is a hindrance for the growth. Because this arrogant self-confidence making small others, looking down others. So this is you are pampering your ego and you are increasing your arrogance. there is a fine demarcation line between the confident, self-confidence, and arrogant. So, how to balance it? So we need the need to humility, humble. We should be humble. Humble means it is also feeling moderate or low view of one's own importance. It is also feelings. Feelings of modest or low view of one's own importance. So this humility or humbleness is a strength, not weakness. If a person is humble, he is more able to empathize with others' people and helps others to grow, and it helps learning from others. It helps us to be more forgiving. Humility helps this way. Whereas self-confidence, they cannot have the power to enter into others' mind because they are so egoistic. So a humble person acknowledges their failure and shortcomings. They are open to others, reach the others. They give respect to the people in lower status as much as the higher status. So self-confident, arrogant, and humble. So self-confidence and humble, these two provides a perfect balanced personality of human beings. That is required. Self-confidence is also required. Humility, humbleness also required. Confidence and humility actually provide the perfect balance of the personality. So this is stops turning. Humility stops turning confidence to arrogant. So there is a proverb, humble on the outside, confident in the inside. So both is required. Self-confident has a turns to arrogant if he has no humility, but humble. So be humble and be confidence, both are required. And it is, you can build your confidence just practicing, constant practicing. And constant practicing with faith. Okay.
Yes, Swamiji. So you have nicely highlighted today about so many things on confidence. But before concluding the session, many of our viewers are not aware of the reference given by you on Kathopanishad. So I am just highlighting that shloka, Bahunam Imi Prathamaha Bahunam Imi Madhyamaha Kim Svidha Yamasya Kartavyam Yan Madhyaya Karikshati. So Nachiketa's thought were, what is the business of Yama that is being achieved through me? Why should I go to him? I have served my father well. I may be the first or at least the next, but not the worst. So this was the point. I may be the first or at least the next, but not the worst. What is the intention of his offering me to Yama? So in relationship, what is this shloka, Swami?
No, shloka, you see, this is a different context that offering we are discussing, not discussing the punishment. But here I want to take, so we should not be lower and look upon them as a lower and weak, not able to do it, just to encourage ourselves. So I could bahuna maybe prathama, bahuna maybe madhyama. That means even in the practical sense, you see, you are first among so many, and second madhyama, so many. You are not worst. That is a wonderful shloka to encourage. Give us hope. When you become the thing, the hopeless, I nothing for that. If you think you, there are certain people are there, you are first, even in the hopeless condition, you are first among others, and maybe second from others, not worst. So that is the implication of this shloka. You should not think and lower yourself, make yourself very low, me, you should not make small, that is. So confidence you must carry that I am not worst, I am maybe first, maybe second. This is the implication. Next line is different unless you explain the context why you have to see that there is a different meaning. So next line you don't take.
Yeah, so it means whenever some point of time when we feel very low, then we should think that we are not the lowest, we are not the worst. We had a lot of
yes.
We have, like, for example, something like we can think that we had this opportunity of education, good parenting, we could go to school, we know so many things. So in that way, we can say that we may be first or second, but not the worst.
In any field of the life, don't think you are very small. That is the medicine. That you always think and you compare, you see in your, around you, you are thinking of the lowest animals, but worst. That is not true. Worst are there among you. That is why Upanishad always say that within you, don't think you are very low. You think you are great. I am the first among somebody, second among somebody, and not worst. Whenever you feel very weak and very low esteem, that time you remember this low and compare surroundings. Yes, sometimes you are first, sometimes you are middle, not worst. Then you can build or maintain, build the confidence level, keep the confidence level high.
Yes. So, Swamiji, to conclude, I would like to just summarize today's important points. So, you have highlighted about self-confidence, how to cultivate it. So first thing you have highlighted is importance of practice and have faith in yourself. So if we continue to practice and if we continue to have faith in our own self, we will develop confidence. Secondly, you have given example of Nachiketa, where bahunani madhyama, bahunani prathama. It means whenever we face difficulties or challenges and low self-esteem, we should always think that we are first among many, we are at least second among others, and we are not the worst. So we should not think worst about ourselves. We should think that yes, we are better off in many situations, even if not first, but we are second. So this helps in giving positive hope and building confidence during crisis. So thirdly, you have highlighted that we should not be arrogant. There is thin line between arrogance and self-confidence. we should be humble outside and we should have confidence inside. So humility, yes. So humility is the major, and also you have said that we should not, in the name of confidence, we should not look down upon others, and we should not get, we should not expect all the time that get into that habit that people should praise me, and we should start looking down on others. So one should be humble, and one should help others to grow, provide them opportunity. So it helps us in developing forgiveness and patience. And so one should have modest or the opinion one should not carry as very high upon ourselves. So one should carry as I am a modest person. There should not be tinge of arrogance to it. And these were